Fortress on Saturday evening coming up. I'm required to fly my troops potentially from an oil rig, and I don't know how big the landing platform is. So in order to ensure that I can do this, landing, taking off, all that kind of stuff, I've chosen a really, really unreliable platform to practice my landings on. So what we're going to do first and foremost is we're going to begin with a small chopper, and then we're going to begin with a really, really, really big chopper, and then see what we need to do in order to get the bigger choppers on there. The actual chopper I'm using, the platform I'm using is over here. And when you see it, you'll be like, oh goodness me, you know, that's going to be easy. But actually, as we start to do it with some of these bigger choppers, it's going to be a real, real problem. And my assumption has to be that the size of the platform is going to be very, very small. I'm not aware of any big platforms per se which can be used, so I'm going to assume the worst and hope for the best. Okay, here we go. I notice I'm in advanced flight as well, so don't usually use the advanced flight on our server, but it won't do me any harm at all to get some practice in with it. It's been a while since I've flown on the advanced flight model, actually. A couple of days at least. Okay, here we go. So I'll just do nap of the earth kind of stuff to get to the platform. So what I did is I stuck a military rusty tower into the seabed, and then on top of that I placed a in fact, here we go, we should be able to see it now. I placed a petrol station on top, which gives us the nice small area to land on of a petrol station. Now then, I can't actually see the petrol station. But this is the best way I thought I could simulate a platform without knowing exactly what it is I'm going to be touching down on. Oh dearie me, what's going on here? Oh, I nearly rolled it then. Okay. Okay, so let's just get ourselves in. Just control that descent for now. Level off, bring that nose up, and let's have a look. Okay, just trying to control my descent here. It's a very small platform. I don't care if it takes me a few minutes just to get myself in with this. But I do want to make sure that I can get it down safely. I just seem to be funneling around it right now, and I'm not very, very happy about that. So what I'm just going to do is just take a little bit more control, reduce the amount of sway and roll we've got in here at the moment. Because funneling around, it's doing me no favours at all. Okay, here we go. Dear, I don't even know if this station will actually hold me, you know. I hope it doesn't, like, fall through or blow up while we land on it. It should be fine. It should be fine, shouldn't it? I don't think it should be any trouble. Okay, so here we go, just nudge it forward, bring us in. Nope, didn't like that at all, just gave it a bit too much forward movement. In standard flight model, it'd be like, oh, you know what, just slam it down. So let's just take that approach, slam it down, there we go. That's on the middle. Okay, excellent. What we'll do is we'll back off from there as well. Alright, brilliant. Let's do that just for a second time. And what we'll do is we'll go around the island, do our approach, just make that one time, just a little tiny bit more challenging, get a look in at it. The way this sea is looking right now, and all of these updates have made just to Noah look, and the waters look, everything just looks so much more beautiful. And it's running a lot smoother as well, which is very, very good indeed. Okay, so there we are, just going to swing that tail end round. There we go. I don't want to get into any kind of ring state there, so let's just control our attitude. Okay, we're coming in now. I just want to bring it in, just give it a touch of power there. Level her off. I'm using the artificial horizon right now. I'm not even looking at the station itself. It's peripheral only. Well, I think that was a bit harsh to be fair, but okay, it is what it is. That's fine. I can live with that. That's what this is all about. Okay, we will respawn. Respawn. Okay, I didn't actually necessarily mean fair, but fair enough. Whee! Superb. And what we'll do is we'll swim back to the top. Excellent. And what we'll just do now, medical menu. Left leg bandage. Super. Right arm bandage. That'll be good. We got no more bandages, not to worry. We're gonna go back to here, we'll respawn. Teleport here. Healed player, brilliant. There we go. Right, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go to configure, configure game, go from advanced to standard. I think on Saturday we will be on standard flight model. Okay, so what we're going to try for now, I think we'll try for the UH-60. Engine on. Here we go. So there's a greater than 80% chance that this is the chopper I'm going to be flying on Saturday for the mission. I have no mini-map, but then again I'm not really bothered. Let's see how we do with this one. Okay, track IR seems to be working well. Okay, let's go. In fact, you know, just before I do, let me just do this, configure video. It's going to go all the way up. Yep. Ultra, ultra, ultra high. Brilliant. Continue. It's going to go here. Client side. 11,000. Grass very high. Set weather. I'm not looking for fog. I'm not looking for rain. I don't mind the rain. Just can't see very far. That's my big problem at the moment. Okay. Let's go. Okay, so we're going to do this again, this time in this bigger chopper, and we'll see what happens. Yeah, I need to get rid of this ring, so I've turned the view distance up. I've turned the MCC view distance up, and it's still not making a big difference in terms of how far I can see, which is a little bit annoying. Okay, a kilometre away, so what I'm going to do is going to begin to decelerate. There we go. That's our target. Oh dear, now I've got the wreck of another chopper on there. That's absolutely brilliant. Okay, well that's not going to prove very useful, is it? Wonder if there's a way I can nudge it out of the way. Or is it just going to kill me? Bear with me a second. I'm going to go into auto hover for a second. This is one of the only good uses for auto hover. Let's go here. Okay, so we've just used Zeus to get rid of it. Now I'm just going to back off slightly just so I can check that it's not there. Yeah, perfect. Okay, there we go. Alright, let's try this again. Auto hover is now off. Okay, now this is significantly longer than the little bird, and with the little bird I could really come in at any angle, but with this one I think I'll need to be diagonally on, just to give me the greater distance between one side of the platform to the other. So that's what we'll do. We're going to come in, keep the nose centre, and then I'm going to use a visual reference out of my right hand window to approximate where my wheels
pull up. Pull up.
Oof, dearie me, it's not brilliant at all, is it? So. Okay, well I need to get further forward of that marker for sure. So let's do that again, and we'll get further forward of that ridge across the middle. I can get the wheels further forward of there, that would be ideal. Again, I don't know if I'm going to be landing on a real, you know,
pull up.
Helipad style platform. Oof. Do you know if anybody could get in on that? That's still a bonus. It's not a crash, I've not killed, I've not died. But if I can do it in that, I'd be alright with that. Yeah, I've not seen any of the helipad models on Steam. I don't know if they're going to be any use per se, but yeah, if I can get onto this small thing, if it turns out to be a proper platform such as the one you would find on, let's say, the hospital at Altis, then we know we're going to be fine. But I'm just going to assume the worst because I don't know what I'm going to be walking into. It's a user-made scenario. Could be just something just like this, so we don't know. That's a bit better, got the wheel down on it. Okay, again, so we've done it a couple of times now, so I'm comfortable I'd be able to at least land on a small platform like this and get a result of some kind, which is good. So let's go back to the airfield. And we're going to swap it out. And this time what we'll do is we'll try a Chinook. And this time with a Chinook, I don't think I'm going to get to land a Chinook on that platform. We'll have a go. But what I actually fancy trying with this would probably be a pinnacle landing. So I'll just tuck the back end around the rear of the platform and see if we can get everybody loaded. Again, I just have to make an assumption that this platform is going to be rudimentary in its design, and I'm going to be required to make some kind of technical pickup of the guys. So, as I say, I'm going to make an assumption of the worst and hope for the best. So what we're going to do is we'll try this Chinook, which is just ahead of us. Okay, there we go. Let's get down there. Okay, engine off, get out. So if we look at the gap in the wheels from this model, I think they probably are about the equivalent actually of what we're going to see on the UH60. So this is going to be challenging. This is going to be really, really challenging. Can I see down the back of the... Yes, I can. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to level the ramp. So we've got a level ramp. So worst case scenario, what's going to happen is if I can't get this down on top of the platform for Saturday's mission, if I do end up flying this, then at least I'm going to be able to attempt a pinnacle landing. So right now I'm going to attempt to do a standard touchdown on this small platform I've built, and if I can't get them down on get this chopper down on the platform, then at least I might be able to get my guys off in terms of using a pinnacle landing and have them get on board that way. So let's do that now. Let's have a trial of this one. This isn't going to be easy. This is going to be quite hard. I'm going to expect to probably crash and burn on this attempt. Okay, definitely coming in a bit hot with this one. Let's get that nose up. I'm going to roll it over.
Caution, ramp.
Yes, it's just warning me that the ramp's down. I'm not bothered by the fact the ramp is down. Just going to put some power back in them rotors. Have I got an eye on this? So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to cheat a little. Just going to put the chopper over the ramp, then we'll go to an external view, take a look. That's the only way really to appropriately measure this one, I think, without risking life and limb.
Pull up.
Yeah, there's no way I'm going to get all the wheels on that, is there, really, let's be honest. Okay, so what we're going to do with this one is a pinnacle landing. Now, this is probably, another one of those scenarios where it's one of the only scenarios you would actually say we're going to do a pinnacle landing using auto hover. So what you'd want to do is just get yourself visually sorted. So you've got your eyes in, put an appropriate distance in there. If we've got 22 metres. So I don't want to change from 22 meters. I'm not happy now with my orientation. And if I just swing that around now, hold on, and I look down the back, we should now see the white of the platform. Okay, 23 meters, that's no use. Where's the platform gone? No, that's no use. It's going to be off my right hand side, isn't it? There it is, yep. We drifted away. There we go. Okay, super. Just going to tip the chopper to the right. Swing that tail around. And once I've got it and I can see it, in fact, I'm not seeing it at all now, we're drifting away from it still. There we go. Okay, let's just use the landscape here as a tall. We're at 35, 34, 33 meters now at the altitude. Just going to bring it into 23. That's not going well at all. Hold on, I'm going to reset myself up here.
Pull up.
There it is. Okay, here we go now.
Pull up.
Doesn't want to do this. Set ourselves up again. Okay, here we go. This is going to be it now. This is going to be it. Are we there? Have we got it? Yep, we've got it, I think. Just close that distance. We're drifting away again. We're just going to give ourselves some right hand roll and then bring the vehicle round again, just inducing some right hand roll. I'm going to decrease throttle slightly, bring it around. Okay, there we go. Now which way are we going? We're going to the left, so we need to tilt it now to the right slightly. Can't be far off there now. There we go, that's perfect. So we're just going to roll it back to the right. 21 meters, happy with that. Oopsie-daisies, how did I not see it? Just bear in mind that there'll be people on the platform going left a bit, right a bit, left a bit, right a bit, left a bit, right a bit. Okay. Okay. There we go. Super. Visual references here. Okay, let's go back to base and get a bigger chopper. So we can do it with the Chinook. It's going to be a bit of wrestling, but we can do it again. If the platform's big enough, then we'll set it down. But based on a platform the size of that garage roof, we're not going to be able to set a chopper this size down.
Caution, ramp.
Yeah, the ramp's down, so let's... open ramp. a level ramp. Okay, I think we're going to go for the CH-53 Sea Stallion.
Caution, ramp.
Super duper. Let's just move this forward. Great. Now then, I think this Sea Stallion might actually have a chance of touching down. So we're going to have a definite...
Caution, gear, down.
Open ramp, level ramp. Okay, manual fire? Manual fire of what? Okay, it's a laser. Not bothered about manual fire of that then. Cancel manual fire. Engine on. I don't think I've actually flown this one in game. Okay, ramp is open. Just can't see down the back, but it tells me the ramp is open. Okay, whatever. Right, let's do this. Gear up.
Caution, gear up.
Okay, feels just a little bit touchy. Okay, yeah, just see, actually it doesn't feel too bad actually, it's not a bad flight model. Okay, there's the platform up ahead. Just kill the airspeed, bring the nose up. Bring the gear down.
Caution, gear, down.
Actually, I quite like the view I've got from here. Actually, it feels like I've got a nice view from where I am. Okay. Let's see how we do. Okay, it looks like it would never have fitted, to be fair. So again, this would be one of those where you'd probably need to do something like a pinnacle landing.
Pull up.
On the back end of this one as well. So let's just have a try at that with this model. Okay, I like the fact I've got a heads-up display on this one, that's good. Okay, Okay, still good enough that my teams would probably be able to get in on a ramp like that. So this is much easier to control than the Chinook. Can we see anything down there? I can't see anything down the back, unfortunately. But again, I would probably have somebody telling me something like, you know, back a bit, up a bit, round a bit, whatever. Yeah, so there we go. Okay, that ramp is closed. I like that. I actually like this model. I think it's a good model. Auto hover off, and then we'll go back to base. Landing.
Pull up. Pull up. Caution. Gear up.
There we go. And we'll do a below 10 meters approach into base. Meters. Yeah, kind of like this model, it's not bad at all. Sea Stallion, I think it's called. Yeah, very good indeed. Just right keeping it out of the water now while I'm in the external view. But yeah, not a bad model at all, quite like it. You never know, I might end up flying this at weekend. So all in all, we've been able to do something with that little platform I've put together. That's quite pleasing, quite satisfied with that. Gear down.
Caution, gear down.
Okay, brilliant, here we go. Let's just... So in the truer sense of things, I've put down a Merlin. That's also British Armed Forces chopper. So that also might be one we're going to use. So let's have a try with that one. Again, I think the wheelbase on that's too wide, so this could be a pinnacle landing as well. Using the it's a big one, that isn't it? Okay, this could be a pinnacle landing as well using this chopper. Can be quite challenging this one. So get in this pilot, and then we'll make our way straight away over to the landing area. We can see all the way down this one. What have we got for a? Okay, we've actually got doors on this one, left door, right door, so if we even landed to the left or to the right of the... So let's just open the doors, let's see, open left door. So even if I brought them in that side, that would be fine. Let's have a look at the ramp, open ramp. Alright, it's definitely a ramp down scenario, isn't it? Okay, here we go. Let's do this anyway. I'm going to leave a ramp as it is for now. I'm going to leave the door open as it is for now. Let's make our way to this platform and see if we can do this pinnacle landing on this platform. Oh, in fact, let's not. Let's try and do the landing first. Close ramp. Gear up. Now this flight model seems a little bit more wayward than the Sea Stallion I've just been flying. It feels just a little bit more wishy-washy. So you've got to kind of like preempt your flight movements before you actually do them. So yeah, this could be a bit challenging. Here we go. Decelerates, gears down. We'll have a look from the outside and see if we need to do anything in terms of the type of landing. So let's just get ourselves over the area. Oh, is it possible? That looks very close, doesn't it? Okay, let's attempt a landing on this one then. I'm going to stick the front wheel down right at the pointy bit. Okay. So we've set ourselves up. I can see where I want the front wheel to be. I'm just going to control that airspeed now. Bringing it in. No, I'm not happy with that. That's not on. I need to be way past that front. Need to be way past the aerial. Oh God, no. Level it off. Power, 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 power. Yeah, that's not happening. Okay, let's
Warning, altitude.
Let's just open the rear ramp. And we've also got the left door as well, so we could probably do a left door entry. So let's do the left door entry first and foremost. Bringing it in, slowing it down. Oh, that's a bit too close for my liking.
Warning, altitude.
Okay, let's try that one again. That wasn't ideal, was it? What I'll do is just disengage auto hover there for a second. And then bring it in to this platform again. Airspeed was our enemy at that point. So there we go. Just engage auto hover at this point, which is an appropriate use for auto hover. Still can't see anything out the side there. Okay, I think that could just be it. Oof, dearie me, that's close, that's close. Not happy with that. Okay, what we'll do is we'll back away from that. And then we'll close that side door. That just seems more risky than actually attempting a pinnacle landing itself. Okay, so what we're going to do this time. Have we got the ramp open? Yeah, we've got the ramp open, perfect. Okay, my track IR is having a bit of a moment here, so just bear with me a second while I reset my track IR. There we go, that's better. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll just bring ourselves in, steady the ship per se, and then at this point if we were to do a pinnacle landing for our team, we'd bring it in like this, engage auto hover. I would expect also to have again feedback from my teams to say left a bit, right a bit, but essentially enough that we could allow our teams to get on board. Had to adjust that then, so there we go. What are we looking at? 21 meters, I think it was. Can we see the platform from there? No, we can't. Can I see it from here? Yes, I can. So we'll just encourage it there, and I'm also going to encourage it backwards. Close that distance down, just using the corner of the station. Increase throttle just to give us a little bit of backwards movement, and then reduce it again, and we're not far off at all. So, you know, if it was going to be, I don't know who's going to mission lead, but they'll be able to close that distance down, but we're not too far off. So we can't get this chopper down on that platform, but if we needed to pick anybody up from there, we could do so using a pinnacle landing and with a bit of guidance down from the ground. So I'm okay there, the controlling of this vehicle is okay. So we've done it in a Sea Stallion, we've done it in a Chinook, and we've done it in...
Warning, altitude. Warning, altitude.
Okay. We've proved what we needed to prove anyway. I'm happy with that. And the practice, I think, has done me a bit of good today. I've Not flown in a little while, so it's just good to be back behind the controls again. If you've watched this and you've enjoyed watching me try and do a pinnacle landing, then hit the like and subscribe buttons, and I'll catch you again soon.
Warning.